my channel. In today's video, I have a very exciting video. At least I'm excited. I'm gonna be sharing with you my top SLGs, small leather goods, slash accessories, all of my favorite smaller designer items. And it's pretty much a Louis Vuitton favorites because I don't really think I have any other small leather goods that aren't like handbags or clutches. So yeah, this is my updated Louis Vuitton favorite small leather goods. So if you'd like to see what my items are, please keep watching. Okay guys, so like I said, these are my favorite SLGs. They're not necessarily my most used, but they are my favorite for various reasons. So let's just get into them. These are in no particular order. I don't really have like a top three or anything like numerically, but let's just start with what's on top. Our first item is my Louis Vuitton monogram card holder. You guys, this is such a great piece. This is one of those pieces where if you're trying to get into luxury, maybe you want to get your first luxury piece, this is something that I would highly recommend just because it's so very useful. Everyone could use it, from like a teenager to a 30-year-old to a 60-year-old, a man, a woman, whatever. Like, you can put this in your pocket. I can use it in my smallest of bags. I can use it in large bags. I can use it in a briefcase when I'm traveling. It really comes in handy. And though it's still expensive because it's luxury and it's Louis Vuitton, it's really well priced when you look at how much it could cost. Now, this is not a full leather piece. Louis Vuitton monogram is actually a canvas, but I love this little baby. Right now I have 1, 2, 3, 4 cards in it, but you could fit a little more. It's not too wide at all. I really love this card holder because it's the slimmest one I own. And honestly, you guys, this is something that I acquired within the past 2 or 3 years. So it's not something that I always had, but I didn't even know that I needed it. Like, this is one of my favorite pieces just because it's so useful. And you guys know that I've really been into mini bags lately, and this is the perfect wallet for a mini bag. I purchased this pre-owned, I believe. I want to say this piece is like 20 years old, but it's in amazing condition. Love it, love it. Okay, next we have another one of my just most favorite pieces of all time. Something that I think everybody needs in their collection if they do collect bags or small leather goods, and it is the Louis Vuitton monogram mini pochette. Highly sought after piece. This is probably, between this and another item in my collection, they are probably the hardest items to find. I don't know what it is about this little piece other than the fact that it's so darn cute and useful. I actually had to get this pre-owned because I could not find it online or in stores, and I want to say this is just a few years old, maybe from like 2015. Let's see, 2016. So this is like 4 years old, impeccable condition. I use this 9 times out of 10 when I'm bringing a larger bag. Now that I'm really into mini bags, I don't use it too often, but when I have a big girl bag, like my YSL Lulu or my monogram Pochette Matisse, this always comes with me. It's a great catch-all piece. I love it because if you don't want to bring a card holder or anything, you can put your cards, your cash, your lipstick, your lip gloss. This is great if you just want to run into the store or to get your nails done. You just put it over your arm and you're good to go. Honestly, I didn't know how much this piece came in handy, once again, until I got it. This is something that I would highly recommend also for one of your first SLGs or pieces overall if you're trying to build a collection. They do make pouches similar to this in pretty much all the luxury houses. I know Chanel has like an O case. I have thought about getting something like that, but I just love this so much. Like, love this piece. It doubles as a cosmetic case, especially in my larger bags that aren't very wide. I'll show you another item that I use instead of it when I am carrying a much larger bag. Okay, next we have the piece that I use every day when I leave the house, no matter what, unless I'm like going out, if it's like date night or I'm going out with friends and I just have a tiny little bag and I just can't use it, this is my Louis Vuitton Monogram 4 key holder, you guys. Another one of those pieces that I just didn't realize it's really a necessity, okay? I love this because I can easily find my keys when they're in my bag. And not only that, if you have a different type of car key, mine, the little slit for the actual key ring to go in is too tiny, so I can't actually put the key in the little holder. But if you can, it's great because you get to protect the interior of your bags. I think I have one bag that has a full leather lining, and so this would be something great for that because you wouldn't want to scratch your bag. I can keep my gym pass in here. If I had other keys I needed, I could keep them in here. It's just such a nice way to keep your keys. And the best thing is that you can carry them around and you don't have to hear them jingling. Like, I don't know about you guys, but jingling keys sometimes can bother me. So having something like this is so, so useful. It's not one of those pieces that you absolutely need just because, I mean, you can use a regular key ring, but it's something that I really love and it's definitely one of my faves. I purchased this also pre-owned. I think this is like 15 or 20 years old also. It's gonna be really hard to see the date code, so I won't even try it. But originally, if you've been following my channel for a while, you know that when I went to New York, maybe 3 or 4 years ago, I purchased the 4 key holder with the pink button and the pink interior, which I really, really like. But the problem with that is that the button is painted on, so it scratches off, and I had to get it repaired. And after that, I was just like, I'm not about to be going without my key holder for months so I can get the button repaired. So I sold it and I bought this, and I think I saved probably like 20 or 40 bucks. It was totally worth it. I also really like pre-owned, you guys, because the quality a lot of times is a bit better. Well, a lot better. So I will leave down my how to purchase pre-owned video down below. But this is definitely another one of my favorite pieces. Okay, my next item, it's not technically a small leather good. I mean, half of these items aren't just because they're not leather, but this is really not a leather good. This is a scarf, you guys. This is the Monogram Confidential Scarf. And I wish I had the product code number or the whatever that number is, but it was on a corner of this. And when I was in Punta Cana, I broke it because it's not really super, super secure. And I don't even know where that tag is anymore, but I do know that this is the Monogram Confidential Scarf. It is 90 by 90 centimeters, I believe. I love this scarf. I don't wear it to bed. I'm not that fancy. I got this, it had to have been like a year or a year and a half ago, something like that. But I like wearing this when I'm going on vacation and I'm out by the pool. Let me show you why it's so amazing. Because you just wear it like this and you look so effortlessly chic, especially on a really windy day, or maybe it's the last day of your trip and your hair is just wrecked. This comes in such handy. You look chic, you look classic. It gives you a little bit of fashion, darling, and it is just amazing. I do have other Louis Vuitton bandeau scarves, but honestly, I really don't wear them. They don't really stay in my hair. They slip out. For me, my bandeau does not get used. I've never sold it just because I do still like it. I got it for my birthday 1 year, but I don't use them. But a good Louis Vuitton scarf, love, love this. And the great thing about the scarves is that every year they come out with something different. So even if you can't find that one, you can find another one that probably looks even better and it's more colorful. Okay, next we have a wallet, and this is my Louis Vuitton Sarah wallet. This is an older style. This is probably the OG style. Now it's more of an envelope style, and the tabs come into a point below the button. I love this wallet so, so much. I believe I got it in maybe 2013. I'm not sure. I got it for myself as a gift when I graduated with my master's a long time ago. This is what the interior looks like. I still have a few cards in here. I love this wallet. This is the wallet that I use most often when I have a larger bag. But recently, since I've been into small bags, I really haven't worn it too much, but it is still my favorite larger wallet. It's simple, it's effortless. I did have some issue with glazing on the side, and I want to say that I did get this fixed. I think I have. But since then, I haven't had any other issues. I really love a Louis Vuitton wallet because as long as they can verify its authenticity, you can get it repaired. Such a staple, it's such a classic. It's my favorite full-size wallet. Now, my favorite small wallet in terms of being a compact wallet is Louis Vuitton again, but it's my first one that I'm going to share with you that's not Monogram. This is the Louis Vuitton Victorine wallet in the Epi leather print. So my last wallet I bought brand new from the store. This one I bought pre-owned from eBay. I love pre-owned Louis Vuitton. I think I bought this for like $320 and it retails for probably like $850 or something. But the reason why I probably got such a great deal is because it's not very popular. I mean, who's gonna think to get this color combo? But I love it. I wanted to switch it up. As you guys can see with what I've shown you so far, most of my Louis Vuitton items are just regular Monogram because that's what I like. I wanted to get something a little different, but I really wanted the Victorine wallet style because I love how it opens. So it's a compact wallet with a button snap closure, and it opens like this. So you have places for your card slots. You have 6 card slots. You have a compartment under here, a compartment under here, and you also have a place for full-size bills, as well as a zip change purse. So this is perfect for me when I'm carrying a smaller bag, but maybe something that's not like a mini bag. So let's say I'm carrying my Gucci Dionysus small, and I'll insert a picture here. So I really love this piece. I probably will get it hot stamped at some point. Victorine wallet in the Epi leather. Okay, next we have an item that I spoke about a little earlier. This is my Louis Vuitton Cosmetic Pouch PM. This is what I use in my really large bags when I can't, well, not when I can't, but it's when I have more space and I don't want to take my mini Pochette. So this is a lot smaller than my Cosmetic case. Now, this is the limited edition Kusama collection, Yayoi Kusama, a Japanese designer, and it just has like polka dots and dots all over it. Super, super cute. I do have some wearing at the corners though. This piece came out, I believe, when I was in grad school or maybe college. It is very old, so yeah, but I love this piece so much just because it's different. Sometimes I do like to get limited edition pieces in items that are like not everyday pieces that I'm gonna have to carry around and look at every day. So unless I have a large bag, I won't really have to use this. I would like to get it in the Damier Ebene canvas just so that I don't have to have this one all beaten up, but I really do like having a limited edition piece and it has served me well all its years that I've had it. Okay, my next piece is the piece that I also spoke about earlier when I told you guys that there are 2 items in my collection that are so coveted and they are extremely hard to get. And this would be none other than the Louis Vuitton Monogram Toiletry Pouch 26. This is what it looks like. I got this, maybe for my 25th or 26th birthday. I wanted this so much and I probably drove crazy, but at the time I wanted it and it was sold out everywhere. I had to call Louis Vuitton every day and it was always sold out. And one day I was sitting somewhere and I was like, you know what, let me trust my luck. And they actually had it. I got it from a store in Jacksonville. I think I was on a waiting list for this item for like 2 or 3 months in Atlanta with my essay. I think with a couple of essays, and it just never worked out. And I was sick of waiting, and I knew that if I left it up to them, I was never gonna get it by my birthday. So if you watch any of my travel videos, you will know that I use this every time I travel. This is what it looks like. Maybe this is coated canvas and not leather interior. I'm not exactly sure. But this is what it looks like inside. I really really like it because it's wipeable. I do use this for my toiletries. I love this piece so much because it's multifunctional. You guys know I love a good multifunctional piece. So this is perfect for traveling, using with toiletries, but it's also the most chic clutch. Like, can you just see this with like a really long flowy maxi skirt or maxi dress, and you just have this little clutch under your arm? It is perfect. This is one thing you also need in your collection just because it's multifunctional. You can wear it a couple of different ways and it's perfect. So definitely, definitely love that. And my next piece, since we're talking about it, is what I use for makeup when I'm traveling. And it is my Louis Vuitton Trousse 23 or 26, I can never remember. I wanna say it's 23. This was purchased pre-owned. I got this off of eBay once again. This is a discontinued vintage piece. Love it, love it. I would definitely only use this for makeup. I wouldn't necessarily use it as a clutch, but this is what the interior looks like. It's the newer style. You have these little like elastic bands right here to hold three things. You also have a slit pocket, and then that is what the interior looks like. Same interior as the toiletry. This fits all my makeup. I love it. If I'm traveling and I can't fit my makeup in this, I have too much. Love it, love it, love it. Okay, my next item is another one of those pieces that I didn't know how useful it was until I got it. This is the Louis Vuitton Damier Ebene Neverfull pouch. And I actually do not own this Neverfull. I purchased this pre-owned from a Louis Vuitton Facebook group. And I'm not gonna link it down below because it's always getting shut down. And then like 3 years later, somebody's gonna watch this video and ask for it. And it's probably not even gonna be up. But if you are a member on Facebook, just search Louis Vuitton Addicted Buy, Sell, and Chat. That is usually the name of it. So I decided to get this pre-owned because clearly I can't purchase it by itself because I don't want to get that Neverfull. I'm not really into Neverfulls, so I knew that it wouldn't really make sense for me to get it. But I started watching videos and I realized that this bag is super, super useful. Now, it's not something that I've used pretty recently just because I've been into tiny bags and so I don't really need this. But when I worked a job out of the house, and I had to bring a large bag and I wanted to go on lunch or go out after work or something like that, this came in such handy. It's also great for going to the nail salon and the hair salon because you don't have to lug around a huge bag. It has a little strap that can connect onto a D-ring inside a bag, or you can just carry it like this. That is my preferred way to carry it. I also really like taking this on vacation. You can put your camera, your phone, your card case that I mentioned earlier, lip gloss, room key, like you're good to go. And it's so effortless. Once again, you can carry it under your arm like a clutch. You can carry it like a wristlet. If you do not have this piece, you need it. The only way you are able to actually purchase it from Louis Vuitton is if you already have a Neverfull and you just need a replacement piece. I love it. I will never give this up. Like, once I got it, I was like, oh my gosh, where have you been my whole life? Because it's amazing. My last item, I debated whether or not to include this because it doesn't get a lot of use, but I'm gonna talk about it. It's still one of my favorites though. This is my Louis Vuitton Monogram Zippy wallet. I got this for Christmas maybe 3 or 4 years ago. The Monogram pieces, you can put your initials. So I have three of my initials. I have a lot of names. And I got the burgundy and the fuchsia stripe. I love this piece so much because it's personalized. Like, who doesn't want a piece of personalized Louis Vuitton? If you're a collector like myself, this is one of the things I think you should get. And it's nice to have in a small leather good because it's not like, you don't have to walk around screaming, this is my name or something like that. But they do make the Monogram pieces in SLGs luggage and some handbags as well. Love this piece. The reason why I don't use it too much is because this is a silk screening and I don't want it to chip. It has already started fading a little on the back. You can see the white showing through. You probably won't be able to see it right now. I used this for probably a year straight and then I gave it a break because I don't want to get this item messed up. But I just think about what great piece this would be for my great granddaughter to be handed down, something like this. Like, I just, it's an heirloom piece. Like, who doesn't love an heirloom? It has the pink interior as well. Of course, because this piece was custom made. Ooh, it still smells like leather. Mmm. Louis Vuitton leather smells so good. Because this is a custom piece, of course, this was purchased from the store directly. So those are all of my favorite SLGs. I mean, pretty much my Louis Vuitton SLGs. I do want to get more into other brands as far as SLGs. Maybe like a Chanel card case or something, or an O case. So we'll see. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any comments or questions, feel free to leave them down below. I hope you're having a great day. I hope this brought a little sunshine to your day, something light and fun to talk about. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.